Okay, so you want to create a number list in Excel. Well, here are three reasons why you don't want to drag this down. Instead, you are going to use the sequence function. First, let me explain why you don't want to add your numbered list like this and drag down. Well, number one, it's annoying because you have to put the patterns. We have to put a 2 here and then drag this down. So if we have a huge list, yeah, we don't want to do this. This is annoying. Number two reason is this. So let's say we're here. We add the next task and the next one. Well, where are my numbers? Yeah, they're not coming with. Oh yeah, I have to drag it down. But no, I shouldn't drag it like this. I have to drag it down like this. Every time I want to add something and I want this to automatically expand, I have to remember to drag this down. And here's a third reason you don't want to do this. Well, what if you end up deleting stuff in the middle? If I delete this, oh yeah, I have to drag down. Oh yeah, drag down again. No, you don't want to do that. So here's what you're going to do to save yourself from this. You are going to use the sequence function. All you have to do is type in sequence, and you could specify the number of rows that you want. So let's say I'm just going to go with 10. And I press enter. I already have my list. But yeah, that's not good enough for me because I want it to be dynamic. I want it to expand together with my tasks. So what I could do is make it dependent on the number of rows, and I can use the COUNTA function for that. Here, I could define a specific range and add some empty cells depending on how long I expect my range to be. If I don't want to bother with that, I could just select the entire column and then add a -1 here. So the -1 is for the header, right? Because I start my numbering from cell A2. I'm just going to close the bracket, press enter, and that's it. My numbers expand as my list grows. What happens if I delete something in the middle? Check this out. Magic happens. I'm going to delete this and everything stays consistent. I don't have to worry about this. Now, here's also a cool tip that Bob Umlis reminded me of. So if we want this to be different, not just numbers, but we want to be an O, stands for number, space, quotation mark, and sequence. So if you wanted to have such a result or whatever else you want to put in front of the number, you don't even have to bother with this. You can keep this function lean and instead handle that with custom number formatting. So I'm going to highlight the column, use the shortcut key Ctrl+1, go down here and define how I want my numbers to be formatted. So my number formatting is going to be in quotation. I'm going to put NO dot or whatever else you want. I'll add a space and quotation. So that's the text I want. And I want my number to follow. So I'm going to use hash or 0. Both of these represent a number. We're going to go with OK. And that's it. Our dynamic list that updates automatically. Okay, so obviously you can drag this down if none of these three points bother you. I'm curious, if you're a dragger, just put dragger in the comments. If you like it dynamic, comment dynamic. So I'm just curious to see how many draggers and dynamics we have in our community, because going by the comments I have in the shorts version of this video, there seem to be a majority of draggers. Now, personally, I start off as dragger myself, and if it starts to annoy me because my list is always changing, I switch to the dynamic version. The point is that there is no right or wrong. Whatever works for you is the right way. Okay, so thank you for being here. Thank you for watching. Subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet, and I'm going to catch you in the next video.